Hello and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. So in our previous lecture, we have studied about the different joints and links. In this lecture, that is my third lecture on Introduction to Robotics, we will study about the different degrees of freedom for different robots and the representation of joints. So let's begin. So we'll start with degree of freedom, or it is also called as connectivity. It indicates the number of rigid bodies that can be connected to a fixed rigid body through a said joint. So as we have studied earlier, you have the input link and the output link, and it is connected by a joint. So if there is one joint, there will be one degree of freedom, and likewise it will change. So I'll explain you in much detail. So first we'll consider a prismatic joint, or it is also called as a P joint, and it has 1 degrees of freedom. So this is the image of a prismatic joint. Here you can see you have one link. I'll consider this as input link. Then you have another link. I'll consider this as output link. If I name this as I link, if I name this as link J, and the joint between them, that is the prismatic joint. As it has one joint, it is with 1 degree of freedom. Now let's see how it moves. So as you know, prismatic joint is a type of a linear joint. So this is how it moves. It moves up and down. So the sliding joint also comes under this category. So it has one joint, it has 1 degree of freedom. Now let's see the notations. So this link is noted as link IJ. This link is denoted as link JK. And this joint is nothing but J joint. Now, here as you can see, this joint moves up and down. So this distance is a variable distance, and it is denoted as DJ, as J is nothing but the joint. And further, as you can see here, this link has no angle. It doesn't move in this format or this fashion. So theta is denoted as the angle, and which is considered as fixed because this doesn't move. So in short, it has a variable distance, that is DJ, and its angle is fixed. And again, as it has one joint, it is considered as 1 degree of freedom. Towards the next, we have studied about the revolute joint also, or it is also called as R joint, and again it has 1 degree of freedom. So this is how the revolute joint looks. This is one link, or we can call it as input link. This is the second link, or the output link, and this is joint with the revolute joint. So again, this is how the movement of a revolute joint is. This is the input link, this is the output link, and it is moving. And it is moving at an angle. So here, as you can see again, the input link is denoted by link IJ, output link is denoted by JK. So J is the joint. So this will be link I, this will be link K. And here the distance DJ is fixed, as it is not moving up and down. It is not a linear joint, it is a revolute joint. So this distance is fixed. And here, as you can see, theta, that is the angle, is variable. So this angle theta is variable. And again, it has 1 degree of freedom. Next, we'll see cylindrical joint which has 2 degree of freedom. Cylindrical joint is also known as C joint. So this is the type of a cylindrical joint. So here you can see you have one revolute joint and one prismatic joint. So these are the two joints. So it has 2 degree of freedom, which is one revolute and one prismatic. So as we have seen 1 degree of freedom and 2 degree of freedom, so I'll give you more examples of different robots with different degrees of freedom. So for that, I'll explain you with the software Mech Analyzer. So let's move towards that. Okay, so to explain further, I'll open this Robo Analyzer software. So this is the front page or the main page of the software. I'll explain the software in detail as we move forward with the robotics. First, I'll explain the different DOF, that is degree of freedom, as we have just talked earlier in our video. So in this software, you can view and analyze with different degrees of freedom, with the revolute joint and the prismatic joint, as we have just heard earlier in the video. So here you can see different degrees of freedom are there, 1, 2, till 7 it is given. So I'll start with the 1. So when we have 1 degree of freedom, you can select the robot, that is 1P, that means 1 prismatic and 1 revolute. So if I am selecting 1P and click on this tick button, I'll get a robot which has 1 prismatic joint. So this is the prismatic joint. So I'll just play this and see how it moves. So to play, I'll click on this kinetic and click on this play button. So as you can see, this is a prismatic joint with 1 degree of freedom. It moves up and down. So here you can modify this. To modify this, here you have a table given. So it says it is a prismatic joint. Its joint offset is variable. So this moves up and down, which is variable. This angle is fixed. So it doesn't move as it is not a revolute or a rotational joint. Here you have a joint angle theta, the degree by default it is 90. You can change it. You can change the link length, this length of the link. You can change the twist angle. The twist angle is nothing but this angle you can change. Its initial value, initial from where it will start, and its final value. You can change and you can look it. So I'll just change the link length. It is given 0.15. I'll change it to 0.2. So as you can see, the link length is increased. The twisting angle alpha, I'll change it to 45. As you can see, this is twisted to an angle of 45. Earlier it was 90. So you can notice here, this is 90 degree. You can change. But it doesn't matter in this situation. The initial value, it is at 0.05. So it starts from here. I can change this. I can make this 0. So it is start from the bottom. Final value, I'll get it to 0.2. So this height is increased. So this will move from bottom to top. Now if I have to increase the speed, as you can see, it was moving really slow. So to increase the speed, you can decrease the time, or you can decrease the number of steps. I'll change it to 30. Then you have to click upon F kinetic. Analysis is complete. Click on play. So this is how it moves. So it moved from 0 to 0.2. So likewise, you can change the angle by change this to 45 degree. This angle is 45 degree. You can change this to 90. Even back to 90, 180 degrees. So this is 180 degree. So if I move, you can change the way your robot functions or works. So this is 1 degree of freedom. This is moving up and down. Now if I select 1R, that is revolute joint with 1 degree of freedom. As you can see here, this is 1R. So here the joint angle theta is variable. So this will move as per your inputs given. The link length is 0.2. You can change this. The twisting angle, this is the twisting angle, you can change. The initial value, it starts from minus 90 degree and it is going to 90 degree. So let's see how this works initially. So this is the revolute joint. It is moving from minus 90 to plus 90. So I can change this. You can change the link length. I can change to 0.3. I can change this from 0 to, this will move to 180 degrees. So this is how it works, from 0 to 180 degree. You can change the joint offset. This height will just increase, but this will not move. This is just the revolute joint, so this will not move like this. It will just rotate with 1 degree of freedom. Let's see how this works. Okay, so with using the scroll of your mouse, you can move this. Now let's move forward with 2 degree of freedom. So 2 degree of freedom, we get 4 combinations where you have 2P, 2R, PR, that is prismatic revolute, and revolute prismatic. So let's see about 2P, that is 2 prismatic joints will have. So here, as you can see, we have 2 prismatic joint. Here also it is given prismatic, prismatic, the same table. You can change this values and you can make this work differently. So F kinetic, click on play. As you can see, this moved and this moved here. So these are the 2 prismatic joints with 2 degree of freedom. Likewise, you can go for 2R, click on tick, and you can see how this works. These are 2 revolute joints function. So this moved, this also rotated, and this also rotated. You have 2 revolute joints. You can change the initial value, you can change the angle, change this to 45. So let's see how this works. Okay, so this started from the 45 degree angle. Then you have PR, that is prismatic and revolute joint. So here you have, this is the prismatic joint, and here only you have the revolute joint also. So this is how it moved. The prismatic joint went up and this also shifted up. So this rotated the revolute joint and this is the prismatic joint. Go for RP, that is revolute and prismatic. So here you can see, this is the prismatic and this is the revolute joint. You can change the values and you can look how it works. Let's go for 3 degrees of freedom. You have different combinations. You can just select any one, click on tick. You can view here, you have, this is the revolute joint, this is the prismatic joint, this is the prismatic joint function, and change. So this just moved forward. Let's see, because as the initial value and the final value is 90, this didn't rotate it. So I'll just change this. If I change this to 180 degrees, let's see now how it moves. So as you can see, now this rotated. Okay, so from 90 to 180 degree, that is 90 degree. It just shifted to 90 degree. If I want more to move, I'll change this to 0. Now let's see. So this totally moved to 180 degrees. You can change the prismatic values, initial and final values. You can change how it works, the link length and everything you can change. So as you change, it will move. So this is how you can create. Let's show you some more. For 4 degrees of freedom, you have these different types of robots available. This is the SCARA robot. So this is the basic SCARA robot. For 5 degrees of freedom, you have these different robots. You can select any and you can work upon and see how it looks. So this is with 5 degrees of freedom. Here you can see this is the MTAB mini robot where you have 5 revolute joints. So you have 5 revolute joints. With 6 degrees of freedom, you have these different robots. You can see this Puma robot. Click on. So you have this 6 revolute joints. Here you have 6 revolute joints. This is how it works. So you can select these different robots and see. Here you have 2 revolutes, 1 prismatic and 3 revolutes. So total 5 revolutes and 1 prismatic joint. This is how the robot is. You can change its values and you can look. So first we have to study the robot and then we'll see how to build it properly. You can go to 7 and you can check the different types and you can just look. Now the best thing about this is you can create also. Generally in companies you have till 6 DOF. You can create more. Click on new. Here you can enter the DOF. What I like, enter 10 degrees of freedom. Click on OK. So here you can get. Now first it is by default showing revolute joint. You can change. I'll change this to prismatic. You can change anyone. The prismatic joints. You can change the value, the initial value, the final values you can change. You can change the angle of rotation. Angle of rotation can be changed for revolute. Here you can see for revolute, you have the angle. And for prismatic, you have the distances. Because in prismatic, it moves up and down. And in revolute, it rotates at an angle. So selecting this, create robot. So this is what it is created. Click on F kinetic. Click on play. So this is how the robot works. You can move it backwards also the way you want. So these are the different robots with different degrees of freedom. Now as we have seen about the joints, now we'll see the representation of joints. So we have studied all the different types of joint. Now how they are represented. So first, revolute joint or the R joint is represented by this symbol. Here you can see you have the input link, you have the output link, and this circular is nothing but the revolute joint, and this link moves like this, or it is denoted by this symbol, and where theta is variable. Next, about the prismatic joint or the P joint, this is the input link, this is the output link, and this moves back and forth. This is the type of a linear joint, or it is denoted by this symbol. And again here, the D, that is the distance, is variable. Now as you have seen in the cylindrical joint or the C joint, you have both distance and theta, that is the angle, variable. Both are variable. So this is how it is denoted. Next, you have spherical joint. It is denoted by this symbol. You have hook joint. It is denoted by this symbol. And you have the twisting joint, which is denoted by this symbol. You have studied the twisting joint earlier. It twists at a particular point. It rotates itself. And here the angle theta is variable. So as we have studied about the representation of joints, now we'll study about the kinematic diagram using the concept of representation of joints. So here I've considered an example of a robot. Here you can see it has a fixed manipulator, its base is fixed. You have different lengths and different types of joints. Now seeing this figure, you have to draw the kinematic diagram of this robot. So first we'll see this robot, which type of joints are there. It as its base is fixed, then you have this type of joint, you have the twisting joint. So you can see this is twisting, then this joint is fixed, then here again you have a revolute joint, here also you have a revolute joint, then here also you have a revolute joint, and finally you have a twisting joint. So using this, now you can draw the kinematic diagram. So let's begin. So first we have drawn the base, which is a fixed base. Then first you have this twisting joint. This is the twisting. So here you have the twisting joint. Here you have the link. So as you have seen in the representation of joints, this is the symbol of twisting joint. This is the input link and this is the output link. So this is the output link. Next, this joint is fixed, this joint is fixed, and here you have a revolute joint. So this is link, just a fixed link. Here you don't have any rotational twisting or any type of joint. This is the fixed rod, it is attached, but here you have a rotary joint, okay, or a revolute joint. So this moves like this. So as you know, the revolute joint symbol is denoted by a circle. This is the input link, so this is the input link and this is the output link. Next, further again you have here the revolute joint is again here. So we will draw, this is the revolute joint, here you have the input link and the output link. Further here you have the twisting joint, the wrist is attached to a twisting joint, so you have drawn a twisting joint. And finally at the last, here you have a revolute joint, this wrist moves a revolute joint, so you have a twisting joint. And at the end there is a end effector or a gripper is attached over here, it is not shown, but at the end you have a gripper attached and which is a revolute joint. So here I have denoted this as a gripper. So finally the twisting joint and the revolute joint where the gripper is attached. So this is the kinematic diagram. You can draw the kinematic diagram for any type of robot, which helps us to indicate or study the joints for the robot.